Tonight, an ambassador visits campus.
Plus a visit from some four-legged friends. Stay tuned. Troy Trojan Vision News starts now.
From the High Definition Production Center of Troy University's broadcast and digital network, Troy, Alabama's international university, this is Troy Trojan Vision News.
Hello and welcome to Troy Trojan Vision News for April 7th, 2016. I'm Christy Henderson.
And I'm Haley Greathouse. Thank you for joining us this evening. This week, Troy University has welcomed former Ambassador Connie Morella to campus as a part of the school's Ambassador in Residence program. Yesterday afternoon, Morella spoke with students about her experiences in foreign relations.
Connie Morella, Troy University's 2016 Ambassador in Residence, spoke to students last night about the importance of political involvement.
We've invited 8 former ambassadors. And the thing about former Ambassador Morella is she also has 8 terms in Congress.
That's right, 8 terms. But get this, there's more.
I ran for my state legislature. I served there for 8 years. I served in the federal Congress for 16 years, and I served as ambassador for 4 years.
In order to demonstrate how important it is for students to be active in politics, Morella gave accounts of how she used her position in office to pass legislation protecting abused women. However, Morella is concerned that the generation of voters known as millennials are becoming uninterested in politics.
I want to pass the mantle on to them. There are young leaders, and I want to inspire them to go into public service, maybe foreign service, but to do something for the government and maybe run for office.
Considering the lack of diversity found in many legislative bodies and the abundance of diversity found at Troy University, it is especially important for Troy students to become politically involved.
You have 76 countries that are represented here, and I believe very much in the fact that the world is flat, that we are all connected, and Troy University here in Alabama is demonstrating that.
Morella's appearance was made possible by the Troy University Department of Political Science and the College of Arts and Sciences. Chelsea Williams, Troy Trojan Vision News.
Troy's Ambassador in Residence program routinely brings in a former ambassador to campus each spring to share their experiences with students.
When it comes to academics, for many colleges, it is limited to class and assignments. But for some, their classwork expands into full-blown research projects. Today, some of those students got to show off their work. Jordan Elston has the details.
Students had the opportunity to hear ways to help them prepare for life after graduation Thursday at the Troy University Student Research Conference.
Basically, we have a mini conference here for students across the university to present their research and things they've been working on lately.
This is the second year that the conference has been held, and students say that the information acquired by listening to the speakers at the conference will help them attain more successful futures.
I learned that pursuing a degree after your undergraduate degree is good because it can help you in the business world a lot more.
I am a first year graduation student, and I want to learn how to give a presentation, and I just learn from it. How to stand and how to present, how to coordinate with the students and the professors over here. It can give us opportunity for future projects, what we want to do, and if we want to attend any presentations, we can make use of it.
Robertson says that the conference focuses a lot on speaking and that he hopes that through the conference some students discover some hidden talents.
It's a really important experience in terms of public speaking experience and in terms of actually getting feedback on research that the students have been doing. I'm hoping that they'll maybe see that they have some abilities they weren't sure before that they had, and maybe they'll see how they can apply those in the future.
Robertson is hoping to hold another student research conference next spring. Jordan Elston, Troy, Trojan Vision News.
The research conference will wrap up tomorrow and is being held in the Hall of Honor.
Yesterday, Troy University set aside a day to show students their appreciation. Around the world and on Troy University's Montgomery campus, students were treated to lunch or dinner as a part of their Student Appreciation Day.
Every Troy University campus celebrates Student Appreciation Day. In Montgomery, students had the opportunity to stop by Whitley Hall.
This is the second year Troy University celebrated Student Appreciation Day.
Well, Christy, it is coming to a close this semester is, and you know, a lot of students need a little way to relieve stress.
Well, that's right, Haley. And the Student Alumni Association provided a furry means of doing so that had an additional benefit to some local strays. Sherry Cotsum has the details.
You won't typically see animals running around Troy's campus, but today the Student Alumni Association and the Troy Animal Rescue Project hosted Puppies on the Quad to help find forever homes for some special puppies.
Our main goal is to help them adopt puppies and to help bring their bill down. Currently they have like a $3,000 bill, so our main goal is to just support them. I discovered Troy Animal Rescue Project when I was a freshman, and it just didn't really seem like anyone was supporting them the way they needed to be supported. And because they're the only type shelter in the area, I just thought someone needed to do it. So
the Troy Animal Rescue Project, or TARP for short, is strictly foster-based, so finding homes for the hundreds of animals they take in is crucial.
We've had so far over 400 people, and every dog that we've brought here has an app on them for adoption.
The adoption fee for these puppies is only $50, but for a lifetime of their happiness, that's a small price to pay.
The Troy Animal Rescue Project doesn't just take in dogs. They also have many other types of animals, including some that aren't so typical.
We do have a pig that's in our foster program, and we have had several other animals. We've done wildlife, turtles, pigs, pretty much any animal that you can name.
The Student Alumni Association says they plan on having this kind of event every semester so students can relieve some stress and hopefully find a new best friend. Sherry Cotsum, Troy, Trojan Vision News.
And now we're going to take one more look at that Montgomery Student Appreciation Day.
Student Appreciation Day. In Montgomery, students had the opportunity to stop by Whitley Hall for free food and prizes.
Today we're giving them pizza, free drinks, we're going to have a raffle for some prizes. Also, we're going to give away a scholarship.
This day is an opportunity for Troy to give back to the students.
I think it's important, you know, to really show students that we care, that we're glad they're here. You know, we appreciate everything that they do and how hard they work, so we just want to give back a little bit.
Troy University in Montgomery is not your typical college campus. Students range in age and class times, so in order to appreciate all their students, they split up Student Appreciation Day into two different sections, reaching out to traditional students and those that are non-traditional.
Our campus actually divides Student Appreciation Day into two parts because we're a little bit different from most campuses. We have adult learners, you know, people who are working during the day and have to go to school at night, or we have some younger students that would come during the day instead of at night.
And one student says events like this help encourage students to keep coming back, even after graduation.
Without the students, really, there's no place for the university to grow, right? So we get diversity from our students, and we hope to make great graduates here at Troy. And for that to be good, there needs to be an appreciation so that they can then come back as alumni and give back to the community.
And now taking a look at news from around the state. Two men have been found dead in vehicles outside a Gardendale Walmart store in a period of 3 days. But police say neither appears to have been the victim of foul play. Authorities are awaiting tests to determine the causes of death.
A man accused of shooting an undercover officer in Alabama says he was high on crystal meth at the time. Ryan Burkhart apologized to the officer and his family Wednesday while police pushed him in a wheelchair on his way to the Mobile County Jail. Authorities say the officer was shot twice but is expected to recover. Burkhart was also wounded.
Authorities in Birmingham say a woman whose body was found burning next to a dumpster last month had strangulation marks on her neck. Angel Buford's body was found on March 14th by police and firefighters responding to a report of a dumpster fire at an apartment complex. Still to come on Troy Trojan Vision News, the men's tennis team gained two victories last night. Rachel Wolferson has the details coming up in sports.
Plus, Belgian prosecutors are searching for the man in the hat. We will have that story and more coming up.
Authorities released new surveillance video of the only Brussels attacker to escape. I'm Jonathan Vigliotti in London. I'll have that video coming up.
Troy University's Department of Theater and Dance presents the musical Violet, April 6th through the 10th at the Trojan Center Theater for the Performing Arts. The story of a woman on a cross-country bus trip to find healing from a TV preacher, she discovers more than she bargained for. Don't miss this musical, April 6th through the 10th at the Trojan Center Theater for the Performing Arts. Oh, no.
Looks like it's done.
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Now, the latest in Trojan sports on Troy Trojan Vision News.
The men's tennis team shut out Jacksonville State 7-0 and defeated Alabama A&M 6-1 in the Lunsford Complex. Troy has now won 10 out of their last 11 matches ahead of Sunday's senior day. The Trojans cruised past the Bulldogs, starting with an easy doubles point that was clinched. In singles play against A&M, Thomas Fernandez started with 2 6-0 wins at number 6, Jeremy Broad at number 5, and Philip Manson at number 2. Colin McKinley and Marcel Dustart closed out Troy's scoring at number 1 and number 3, respectively. The Bulldogs grabbed its lone point with a third set and tiebreaker win at number 4. The Trojans opened their match against JSU with 6-3 doubles wins at number 2 and number 3. Troy now turns its attention to a full slate of matches on Sunday. It will be senior day for Daniel Bustamante and Giovanni Samana with a ceremony at 1:30 at the Lunsford Complex. The women's tennis team reaches closer to the end of the regular season as the Trojans travel to Atlanta to take on Georgia State and Georgia Southern this weekend. The weekend's matches were originally scheduled to be played in Boone, North Carolina at Appalachian State, but due to the threat of severe weather, the matches were moved to Atlanta. The Trojans have won 3 of its last 4 matches, with the lone loss being its only Sun Belt loss of the season, 4-3 to rival South Alabama last week at home. Troy will face the Panthers at 10 a.m. on Friday before playing the Eagles Saturday at 9:30 a.m. The softball team couldn't overcome 8 runs in the first 2 innings from number 3 Auburn in an 8-1 loss on Wednesday night. Auburn jumped to an early 4-0 lead in the first inning. The Tigers plated 4 more runs in the second inning and made the score 8-0. Troy's lone run of the game came in the 5th inning when Heather Johnson sent a solo shot over the left center wall. Erica Davis and Carly Kaler were the only other Trojans to have hits on the night. After facing a pair of SEC opponents, the Trojans turned their sights back to Sun Belt play.
The Sun Belt is very competitive in every team, and every team is somewhere that you're going in and you have to be prepared for. But with coming off of playing, you know, the SEC programs that we just have, I mean, that's great for us no matter what.
The Trojans will head to Monroe, Louisiana this weekend to get back into conference play as they take on ULM in a 3-game series. First pitch of a doubleheader is scheduled for 1 p.m. on Saturday and 12 p.m. for the final game of the series on Sunday. The Troy baseball team gears up for a 3-game conference series at Riddle Pace Field beginning tomorrow night at 6 p.m. The Trojans face off against Appalachian State. The Mountaineers are 8-21 and the Trojans are on a 3-game winning streak with an overall record of 17-13. Head coach Mark Smart says App State is playing well, but hopes his Trojans have the momentum to sweep past them.
Well, they're playing better. And, as a coach, I would have liked to have seen them struggle another couple weeks, Aaron. But, you know, they played well. So any conference weekend, you got to play good baseball to win. So I'm sure we'll have to be at our best. But I'm hoping that their little momentum kind of gets delayed this week and we can get ourselves back in good place.
Saturday and Sunday's games will both begin at 1 p.m. Tomorrow night at 7:30, the soccer team will host SEC opponent Alabama at the Troy Soccer Complex. The Trojans are hoping to gain another spring win and keep the streak alive with 3 wins under their belt already. Troy has only allowed 1 goal against them and have outscored its opponents 7-1 this spring. Troy traveled to Tuscaloosa last year but lost to the Crimson Tide 1-0. Troy's goalkeeper Mickey Lewis had 3 saves in the match, but Alabama scored the winning goal in the 77th minute. Following tomorrow's meet with Alabama, the Trojans have 3 more matches left in the spring schedule. Troy will host its last home game at the Troy Soccer Complex with a match against West Florida at 4 p.m. For more information on Troy Soccer, visit TroyTrojans.com.